Divers have recovered the remains of two of the six missing workers, and this more than a day after a cargo ship smashed into Baltimore's Francis Scott Key Bridge. The bodies of the two men were found in a red pickup truck that was submerged in icy waters off the river. Now, the two were identified as 35-year-old Alejandro, who was from Mexico and living in Baltimore, and 26-year-old Dolin Cabrera, who was from Guatemala and living in Maryland. Authorities have suspended efforts to recover bodies in the waters due to treacherous conditions. According to an investigator, approximately 6 hours of voyage data from the Dali cargo ship have been provided to the National Transportation Safety Board.
At this point, based upon the conditions, we're now moving from a recovery mode to a salvage operation. Because of the superstructure surrounding the vehicle, what we believe are the vehicles, and the amount of concrete and debris, divers are no longer able to safely navigate or operate around that. We have exhausted all search efforts in the areas around this wreckage.
The collapse will create a logistical nightmare for months, if not years. The port is a major East Coast hub for shipping. The bridge spans the Patapsco River, which massive cargo ships use to reach the Chesapeake Bay and then the Atlantic Ocean.
Now, the Baltimore port is the 17th largest in the country. The flow of containers to Baltimore can likely be redistributed to bigger ports. However, there could be major disruptions in shipping cars, coal and sugar. It was the busiest U.S. port for car shipments, handling at least 750,000 vehicles in 2023. In 2023, the port was the second busiest for coal exports. It is also the largest U.S. port by volume for handling farm and construction machinery, as well as agricultural products such as sugar and salt. Furthermore, the port supports more than 15,000 direct jobs and more than 139,000 indirect jobs connected to the port.
By this, it generates almost $3.3 billion in total personal income. Now, the collapse, though, is not likely to hurt worldwide trade because Baltimore is not a major port for container vessels. President Joe Biden promised to visit Baltimore soon and said that he wanted the federal government to pay to rebuild the bridge. Now, how long will it take to rebuild the bridge? Of course, that needs to be decided as we proceed further. Rebuilding could be a lengthy process and will depend on whether any of the remaining structure can be salvaged. It took 5 years to construct the original bridge from 1972 to 1977. The closure of the port for just 1 month could cost Maryland $28 million in lost business.